गुड इवनिंग. आई कांट हियर.
गुड इवनिंग.
थैंक यू एंड ए वार्म वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू एट मनीलाइफ फाउंडेशन. टुडे वी हैव आई मीन यू हैव बीन यूज टू आवर आरटीएस सेशंस बट टुडेज सेशन बाय विश्वास इज रियली समथिंग दैट आई एम लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू बिकॉज व्हाट ही हैड डन इज आई मीन वी यूज आरटीआई. सो बिफोर आई डू माई चैटर आई विल आस्क विश्वास व्हाट वांटेड टू प्लीज कम ऑन द स्टेज प्लीज. Vishwas Vaghmode is an award-winning journalist and he has used RTI extensively to bring out the truth in the public domain and he has written articles based on his RTI findings that include some on the Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj Memorial Project, so which information was not readily available, so he filed RTI, he did the inspection, file inspection, and then he got the copies and then he wrote the articles. He wrote a series, in fact, right?
Yeah.
And then again, you all remember that Me Too movement, right? So during that Me Too movement, Vishwas thought, okay, let's find out, because there is a provision in the act that you have to appoint an committee. You have to appoint a committee that is called as Prevention of Sexual Harassment Committee, that is POSH committee. So he thought, let's find out what is the situation in the Mantralaya and the ministries. So he filed RTIs and he found out none of the minister had appointed any POSH committee. So he wrote a story on that, and based on his story, as a reaction of this his story, the chief minister asked all the ministers to appoint the POSH committee. So that is how he's bringing changes into the governance and the our lives. For his work in the field of journalism, he was awarded the State Level Excellence in Journalism Award by the Mantralaya, Vidhi Mandal and Vartahar Sangh. As well as last year, he received the Sajag Nagarik Manch RTI Award from the Sajag Nagarik Manch of Pune for his RTI to report issues on the public interest. So I'll now call Vishwas too.
So I assume, good evening everyone, and thanks Manilife and ma'am for inviting me here to talk about the use of RTI to bring out the issues of public interest. So I will speak on two things. One of my experiences, how I started using, why I am going for RTI inspection rather than seeking information, and then whatever the on my experiences, what I have come to the conclusion of the how to file RTI inspection to specific with the specifics and all that thing. So there is no further delay in getting the information. So I am using RTI. Initially, I used for my when I was in my village. I was just telling Shailesh sir that I filed my first RTI application in 2007 to get information about the government hostels and government aided hostels in Pune. So I'm basically from a village in Sangola, Tehsil in Solapur district. So I wanted to pursue the post graduation Pune. So I filed an application seeking the information from social welfare officer in Pune. I was not expecting any response to that, but fortunately I got the reply, got some of the information, and that though I didn't get any hostel from that list, but I got the information. Then when I came to Pune to pursue my post-graduation and diploma in journalism, at that time I did one day workshop course in Yashoda on RTI. At that time, I met Velankar sir from Pune, and he helped me. I wasn't much familiar with the issues of Pune and all that things. So Velankar sir helped me with one issue. So I filed two RTIs and got the information. And based on that, I did my first story of the journalism career in 2008. That was published then in Pune Mirror as a citizen journalist. Then I passed out in 2009. Then I came to Mumbai and joined DNA as a journalist in June 2011. So I used to file RTIs, but the problem that I used to face is sometimes I would not get the desired or expected information. Sometimes it was late. For us, we have to file stories every day, and we don't have much time to wait for 30 days or something like that. So initially, that was because of the response, I didn't file much RTIs. In 2014, when I was in first post web portal, so in previous year, in 2013, there was an article reported by regional newspapers in Sangli. that the then chief minister's wife got some crop compensation due to, I think, drought or incessant rainfall. So in 2014 also, there was a heavy rainfall in February. And based on that, I just thought ki if they, matlab, they checked about the CM's wife, so I will just check about the Pawar family in Baramati. So I had filed RTI with the Baramati Tehsil office asking them about the information. Only thing I did was that I didn't ask for the information with the specific names. I just find, I just checked the election affidavits of these Pawar families. Checked the their land holdings and the villages that the lands are there, and filed RT mentioned their names of the villages, and just to misguide the PIO, I just mentioned two other villages of the other tehsil. So they gave me the information, and the information showed that the Ajit Pawar's brother and mother has got crop compensation, and the amount was credited into their bank account. Sharad Pawar and Supriya Sule also were eligible for the crop compensation, but it was not paid to them because they did not give the bank account details. So that was one of the good response, or like a kind of a response that I could convert into a story was there. The major or most of the RTIs, or I started using more RTIs or filing more RTI, is when I joined Indian Express in 2016. In Indian Express, there is a culture, a kind of like everyone, like from bosses to everyone, will ask you to file more RTIs, and we encourage, matlab, Express encourage reporters to file RTIs. So in 2016, I was filing a couple of RTIs. One of the issue that year was that the due to the Metro 3 work, there was a lot of tree cutting issue was there, and there was a lot of opposition from the activists, and everyone, citizens were opposing, saying that we shouldn't cut so much trees and all that thing, we should have a rational and all that things. So I just filed one RTA application with the BMC asking for the information about the tree cutting and transplant in last 5 years. I filed my application in December 2016. So that PIO replied me within a week, saying that the information is not available with us. This is, the information is available at the divisional heads of the 7 zones. The application was transferred. So after that, I didn't go, they didn't reply to me. I waited for 30 days, they didn't reply to me. I filed an appeal to the superintendent of garden, who is the first appellate authority. And then he also passed order saying that within 15 days, the information should be given to him free of cost. 15 days went, 1 month went, they didn't give me the information. I went to the, we went for the second appeal to the information commissioner. And it took 3-4 months around that time, because there was not much pendency of the Mumbai region. So within 4 months, he passed order saying that in a month, the information should be provided to the applicant free of cost. A month gone, again, no response from the BMC. So then I went into the complaint. I filed a complaint saying that the your order has not been complied with by the BMC, and proceedings should be initiated under sections of the RTI Act. He issued a notice to the BMC PIO asking why penalty shouldn't be imposed against you and why an inquiry shouldn't be instituted against you. Subsequent to that, in the second notice, the PIO said the information is available. First admission from the BMC came that the information is available. So far, orally they were telling me there is no such information and all that. Then before the information commission, they said give us some more time, we will compile the information, we will give it to you. So it in April 2018, I got the information finally. So it started in December 2016, I got the information in April 2018. In all, it took 1 year and 5 months. When I was, matlab, I was given the information by the PIO, I was having a chat with her, because we used to, matlab, we were become very good friends during that time of the hearing and all that. So she told me, you troubled me a lot. It was from her point of view. You troubled me a lot. You filed RTI, sought information, then went into the appeal, second appeal, complaint and everything. But I am a deputy superintendent garden of one region. I don't have information of all other 6 regions. How am I supposed to give you the information? It is the first appellate authority who should have matlab, done this. So, and I have another charge of another tree authority. So I'm handling that, and then I'm working as a PIO. So it's a lot of workload for me. And so it has matlab, troubled me a lot. And then she told me, ki, henceforth, if you want any information, come to my office and see all the records. I will show you all the records and see for yourself and get the copies of that records, but don't drag me to the commission. So that was the first thing that she told me, the PIO told me. So I just thought ki I spent 1 year and 5 months in getting that information. Then translating into that story was another task. But I realized her words that why I didn't go for the inspection. I thought it's my mistake. Since I'm a journalist, we have to file the stories every day. We can't wait for like 30 days or something like that. So I just thought ki how long, in each case I might not be able to go to the first appeal or the second appeal because I need to deliver the stories, and if I need to deliver the stories, I need to figure out a way. And when she said that ki why didn't you come for the inspection, or whenever now if you need any more information, come for the inspection. So afterwards then I decided, rather than seeking the information, I will just ask for the inspection. I have never filed an RTI inspection application before that. So in July 2017, in the textile department, one of the government resolution was issued. So some of the stories or ideas that come from different things. Some come from government records, notification, government resolutions, annual reports, and all that things. They give a ample of material and hints in that for story. One of the government resolution issued by the textile department said that a garment unit in Solapur city was moved to a rural area, and the land in which it was moved, it was a company of that ministers. One of the company was there, and sensing that, I just thought ki something might be interesting in this. So I just filed an inspection application saying that I want to inspect this file, and I will. So in the RTI inspection application, what I did was I just mentioned the subject of the inspection, and then I gave a date. For example, today is the 12th. I said I will come on 25th for the inspection at 3 p.m. Keep all the records ready for the inspection. And then I quoted section 2, which gives 2J, which gives what the inspection is and how it is allowed. And then I quoted another section 4 for dissemination of the information. I quote reproduced these two sections in my RTI application itself, saying that dear PIO, please note. And then thank you and signature. So I went to the 15 days ka time I had initially given, because I wasn't well versed with the inspection application. So 15 days time, after 15 days I went to the office, then the PIO was a lady, then she said okay, but we can't accept your date and time because we will intimate you and not like you will intimate us. I said fine, but when and how it will happen and all that things. So she was that way kind enough and polite in saying that. So a couple of 4 or 5 days later, she said come and inspect this file. So I inspected. I saw the entire file, Xerox copies of the entire file, because I was worried or I had doubts if I ask specific copies, and if she gets hint that this information pertains to the minister, then she might not give me information. So I asked for the entire Xerox copy of the 350 pages of the file. I got that copy, Xerox copies, within like all the information I got was within 25 days. Subsequently, I did the story. It had a good impact. Then I filed another RTI application saying how minister was using. So in that story came out was that how minister used his powers to force the garment units to shift the existing location to in his constituency, and the land was owned by one of his company. So when I figured out the information and everything, the attempt that minister was making was he wanted that unit to be shifted in his constituency was to build the constituency so that he can, in the polls, he can go to the people and say that, see, I have brought this here, a garment unit that will provide jobs to 350 women in the village. So that was his this thing. So I did that story saying how he used his conflict of interest, like he on his own, he founded the Lok Mangal group in Solapur district, and he was the textile minister. So on his own, in his notings mentioned that why it is not being given to Lok Mangal that land holding that they have in so and so village. And then it appeared from the file that he suo moto did all these things, forcing the unit to go, otherwise I won't release the payment. That was the condition. Then they changed the location subsequently and their payment was released. Subsequent to that, he used different norms for another unit. And I also did one story, like again, I filed another inspection application. So by that time, what had happened, the same PI was there. So she got to know that ki, I'm a journalist. My story created impact that the department had to issue a clarification. And who wrote the clarification? She herself wrote the clarification. And so the good thing was that she could not deny anything, because what I did, I got the file. I went to her, madam, this is the sentence, I didn't understand the meaning of this. This page says so and so. So I clearly told her plainly, like, madam, I don't want to write anything wrong. Whatever is there, I want to write a factual position on that. So please guide me. I did not mention her ki I want to write against minister or like something like that. So she explained me everything, and next day, like she was, we went to the publicity division of the government. I had gone to meet someone and she was there. When I saw her, I just said hi to her, and she said, I am here to explain on your story. Give an explanation on that story. So when I filed next RTI, then there was no problem. I gave her 12 or 15 days time. She said, come and inspect. On the same day, inspection was done. On the same day, the file was, the next day, a letter was issued saying that pay this much amount. And within 2 days, I got the information. It is because that she understood that ki, he's a journalist and filing stories. Prior to that, she wasn't aware ki, I'm a journalist and I'm going to do a story on this. So that helped in the next inspection. So these two stories I did on this, how the textile minister was misusing his powers as a and conflict of interest of him. Then I randomly, as a journalist, meet many people. So I was meeting one of the undersecretary in the department. So he gave me a specific tip saying that how two garment units, we were having a chat key. So he was saying, you don't write against government and you just write whatever they say and they give a press note and all that things. You report on that, you don't write anything against. So I asked him, if you have anything specific, give it to me, then I can check that out. So he gave me two specific file numbers and names saying that in these two cases, how these people have cheated the government, how they have tried to get the government funds and they didn't want to do the project and everything. And then he gave me that detail. So I filed RTA for that two files with the textile department. The PI was again same, because this cases were the same. The PI again helped, and because PI got to know that I'm doing some of these stories and all these things will, matlab, the irregularities will come out. I filed that RTI again, and it came out that the CM had instructed on paper saying, one of the BJP functionary had wrote on paper saying that please issue funds to these units. These are from Marathwada and we need an employment generation here, and please issue. So CM apparently had demarked saying that tatkal karyavahi karavi. So he didn't, the officials didn't check the regulations and rules, what it said and what was the violation and all that thing. They randomly issued the payment. So after my story appeared, the CM ordered an inquiry into that. Though, as usual, the inquiry gave the clean sheet to the two units, and it continued. Just 8 days back, they have been given another slot of funding, and they are continuing. But the inquiry was ordered in this. Then again, so it was in like March 2018, if you remember, the CM had announced that we have negotiated the Shivaji Memorial project with the contractor. The cost that the contractor had quoted was 3,826. That was the lowest bidder. The government estimate was 2,600 crore. That was much higher than the estimated cost. The government set up a committee led by the chief secretary to negotiate with the contractor. Normally, once the L1 bidder is finalized, it is difficult to negotiate with him because the rules doesn't allow. Renegotiation doesn't happen because then the one needs to go for re-tendering rather than renegotiation. In this case, they reduced the cost to 2,500. I was surprised with the fact. They issued a letter of acceptance to the contractor saying that you should complete the work within 3 years from the date of letter of acceptance. I was curious, the state assembly session was going on. I was curious, within 7 days, the opposition parties in the legislative assembly alleged that the government has reduced the height of the statue to cut down the cost. Government denied that allegation. And I was like amused, what's happening? How come, if my curiosity was, if the contractor had quoted 3,826 in his original bid, how did he come down to 2,500? What was the reduce? Something might have been reduced, something might have been done. And when I met the secretaries, or engineers, officials, everyone was tight-lipped. Even I met the concerned elected representatives who were heading the project and all that things. Nobody was ready to share any information. They made me run after them for 1 month. since the session was going, I didn't have much time to get the information or chase them much. But every week I used to remind them, but didn't get any information. So in April, I decided now I need to sit down and needs to fix this issue. So I filed again RTA inspection. Now in this case, I didn't know file. I just know that this is a Shivaji Memorial Development Project. I don't know a name of the file. I don't know anything. So I just figured out in which is the authority that handles this project, because every project is handled by a particular authority. So I figured that out. There is a project division for the memorial. So I filed RTI with them, just saying randomly, I want to inspect files of the development of Shivaji Memorial Project. The PIO said ki PIO was like an administrative person. He said, aap aaj aake dekh jao, mujhe kuch pata nahi hai usme. While he was explaining to me, he had showed me one image showing that how the cost was reduced. So one of the element of that was, the government had initially said, we didn't reduce an inch of the height of the memorial. The image in that project showed they had reduced the height of Maharaj and the horse. That total size was reduced by 7.5 meters. But to show that the overall height was the same, what they did, they increased the height of the sword. So the height of the sword was increased by 7.5 meters and that much was reduced here. So explaining that to me, the engineer told me, because the sword is straight, it doesn't take 7.5 meters, it won't take that much material to build that or to have that, but the Maharaj on horse riding Maharaj will require a lot of material, and reduction in 7.5 meters has helped the government to reduce 3.50 crores. Then session was going on. Immediately the story appeared. It went all the opposition parties took that story, saying that ki you claimed that not one inch of the statue height was decreased, but here it shows that 7.5 meters was decreased and the height of the sword was increased. And that was the first time that the government didn't have an answer to the question. The CM defended in the assembly, saying that we have maintained the overall height. But till date, he hasn't spoken on why the height of the sword has increased. He has not been able to, and it was the first embarrassment or big setback for the government, because he was so confident. It was clear that the BJP wanted to use it for the political gains during the polls. That's why he was so confident and insisting that we haven't done. But when they saw the image of that specific report published in the newspaper and the opposition parties took it, he got it that we have messed it up. The government has messed it up. The story appeared. Next day I filed RTA with the Mantralaya, that particular PIO and everything. I inspected the files. There were, again, I didn't know a particular name of the file. I didn't know a number of the file and nothing. I just filed a random RTA inspection, saying that I just want to inspect this. So there, what happened? I gave a particular date, for example, 23rd September, no, 23rd August, but the PIO didn't like. Normally what happens when we give them a date, normally I give them a date, some PIOs are okay with that, some are not. They feel that we are the boss, you are not. So when I submitted the application, it was 23rd August or something. 3 days before that, or 4 days before that, a letter was sent to me saying that don't come on 23rd, come on 24th. But on the same time, like 3 p.m. So he was having a problem that I give him a time. So he wanted to show me that he's the boss and he has given me the time. So I said, fine. So I inspected the file. I received some of the documents there, and subsequently from Mantralaya I had got some 300-350 pages. As usual, I asked for the entire file. I didn't ask for specific pages. And then I got to know that there are several letters pertaining to the Chief Engineer's office and to the Project Division's office. Then I filed applications to his office and to another Chief Engineer office. Then the information, then there were several letters and documents and information that was coming in and all that things. The project division, since this engineer knew that I will do a story on this, but then I realized that this fellow doesn't have an intention to deny me the information. This fellow hates RTI only because he feels that ye jyada kaam hai, uska mujhe kuch paisa nahi milta hai. That was my impression that I got. And then I had a chat, and then next time what I did, so in the same this thing I told him, sir, that's fine if you don't like all these things and all. So I said the next inspection is on this and this date and this time. So you do one thing, you keep the files here, ask Pune to sit with me, I will just inspect and go away. I don't want to bother you. I don't want to take your valuable time. I don't want to disturb you at all. I am just concerned about this much information that I am interested. So you are saying, we will do that. There is no problem then, because I will be able to carry on with my work and then you can carry on with it. And since then, I must say, we have become very good friends. So I continue to happen. But the recent government order has helped me out to file less number of applications. In 26th November 2018, the government of Maharashtra has issued a letter replicating the Pune pattern across the state. The Pune pattern is that every Monday, in except Mantralaya, you can't go to Mantralaya, but except Mantralaya, in all the offices, regional offices, district level offices, divisional offices, in all the offices, every Monday, between 3 and 5 p.m., you can go and inspect the records. So there is no need for you to wait for 10 days, 15 days. So my work has been reduced because of the help of the government. So in between of these, while these experiences I was getting, on the other side, I had filed one RTA application with PWD, one with respect to the Shivaji Memorial. So in Mantralaya I had filed. The interesting part was that, so these PIOs are very strange guys. You will never know how this person is until and unless you see the reply or you interact with that. So I filed RTI with the Mantralaya PIO asking for the inspection. So one meeting was held between CM and all the Shivaji Memorial stakeholders, including PWD engineers, consultant and contractor. That was an unofficial meeting. Nobody had taken anything on record. Nothing was on record. By mistake or deliberately, I don't know, but the consultant of that project brought that meeting on record, saying that this meeting was held on so and so date by this person, and subsequent to that, he conveyed some of the messages. So I got the copy of the letter and filed RTI with the Mantralaya, saying that give me the minutes of the meeting of this particular meeting. So I filed RTI and I met the PIO. He said, "Aisa kuch meeting hua nahi hai." I said, "Fine, give me that in writing." So he said, "Okay, we will inform you in writing that no such meeting has been held and no records are available." So what happened, he issued a letter, but the letter was very interesting. It said, "All the minutes of the meetings of the High Power Steering Committee of the project are available in this office. But the minutes of the meetings of this particular this meeting are," in Marathi the wording was, "Ya baitakiche itivrutta babachi mahiti niranka ahe." That was the wording that they used. So I said that was also fine. But the next line was more amusing and interesting. He said, "Tathapi, apan sadar mahiti che parikshan karnya karta amukamuk divshi amukamuk veli yeu shakta." I was like, if the information is nil, then why are you asking me to come and inspect? There was no point asking me to come and inspect. So I said, if he is playing the trick, so I also must play a trick. I went on the same day. I said, "Show me the information." So he said, "There is no information." So I showed that PIO letter saying that you have written, "Ya babatchi mahiti niranka ahe ani tumhi tapasni sathi amuk amuk divshi yeu shakta." I want to see that niranka, nil information. Show me the nil information. He was like amused and saying he didn't know how to respond to that. So I told him on his face, "Look, if you don't have the information, say so. Don't waste my time. Why are you playing the trick of saying that there is a nirank information and then you asking me to come and inspect the information?" So there are such PIOs in the in the Mantralaya that I came across, and you never know who will respond. This is one of the example of that. Then I am coming to another point. As usual, I was interacting as a journalist. I interact with multiple departments. The plastic one was being enforced by the environment department. So I was interacting with the environment officials. So in one of the interactions, state level conservation, lake conservation scheme. The scheme is for state level, and lakes from various places, the proposals come to the government for approvals. In that, the case is 10% that the local body has the funds has to raise, and 90% assistance is being given by the government. 14 proposals, lake conservation proposals across the state were approved. Out of that, 11 were from Ratnagiri district. Out of that, 10 were from Dapoli. I was like, why, like, sudden all the state has come to the Dapoli? Matlab, state level scheme has reduced to Dapoli. I was then meeting these officials to get a sense why this person has done this, because he on his letterhead wrote a letter to the committee that was approving the project, lake conservation proposals, saying that these are the 11 proposals, please approve. Committee did took an objection saying that it is an unprecedented proposals. In one financial year, we have never approved so far so many proposals. We can approve in phases, like 2 to 3 in one go, but not more than that. But then they said, since the letter has come from the ministers, we have decided to approve it. I was like, again, that the process of conservation is going on since last year, June, April. So the process is still on. So in some cases, the payment has been released in part. Some cases, the next installment will be released after the completion of the work. So the entire payment, the entire proposals were worth of 15 crore rupees. In that immediate year, 4 crore 55 lakhs were released immediately as a first installment. So that work is going on. They have a period of 3 years to complete the work. So I'm keeping a watch on that as well to see whether he completes the work or not. Then as I have an interaction with another example, I will give you how there are good officers and PIOs in everywhere, like most of the offices. And we, like, this is my own observation or my own experience, that we should never be have a biased opinion about a PIO, saying that he will deny the information, he will hate us, he doesn't like RTA. There are people, but it's not like that every time. So I have filed multiple inspection applications. On an average, my experience is 15-20 days of doing the inspection and getting the information. But you know, this is not the case everywhere again, because when it comes to the higher profile offices or sensitive and major departments, it won't happen. When I filed RTA application with the CM's office, asking, they have a war room. War room has been set up to track the development and progress of the major development project in the state. So I filed RTI with the curiosity to see what they have done in last 3 years. I gave them a date as usual, like 15 days. I will come on this date and will inspect. And when I went, these officials were very reluctant. They, on face, they told me, look, you can't inspect it today. We have 30 days time. We won't allow you to do that. And on 29th day, they wrote me a letter saying that we can't allow you to inspect because it will, they cited the section 7, subsection 9, saying that it will disproportionately divert the manpower of the government to allow you the information. See the mentality again here, since this is a CM's office, they deliberately use this section to deny me the information. So the PIO during the course of interaction told me, you ask for a specific time limit and specific departments. So I revised my application. I submitted it to CM's office saying that give me 6 months, minutes of the meeting. And to my surprise, I was hoping that there might be 2 to 3 meetings every month. I might have to do inspection for 2 to 3 hours. When I went, they gave me only one copy of the minutes of the meetings. They said only one meeting has been held in this time. So it was so shocking for me that I asked him, ki you denied me the information because I asked for last 2 to 3 years. And for the 6 months, you are saying one meeting. How is that? How do I digest this fact? So then he was like hesitant to speak much. But it comes here, the point is that that war room is headed by the CM's additional chief secretary. And obviously he said that whatever we have to communicate with you, we can't communicate directly. We have to take orders from him before communicating you. So that takes a lot of time, and that decides how much information and what information should be disclosed to you. So that was how the experience of the CM. So it will have a different, the PIOs and that experiences, but that helps you a lot. So in our office, we were having a chat. Our bosses were talking about that we should get more stories on the Me Too, and we should figure out what's the happening. So I was told to file RTAs with all the departments, government departments, Mantralaya departments, to check whether the committee actually has been set up. If it has been set up, how many complaints has been received? If complaints has been received, what action has been taken? I filed RTIs with all the departments, and I just thought I should file one with the CM office, because CM has lot people, 120 people staff they have. So I just thought I will just file with one with them. Rest of the departments replied saying that they have set up a committee. 90% cases they didn't receive a complaint, and there is no question of taking any action. In CM's case, CM office case, what happened? That they said the letter was issued initially saying it is with the GAD, the General Administration Department, and you contact them. I said okay. When I went to meet the PIO, the PIO is a very good chap. So he said we have received your application, but we have reverted back to CM office. But I was like, how you are like doing playing football with me? Like, why you are doing this? So he said, he explained me a concept, and there he gave me a story itself. So that's why I feel that we should have always a good and healthy interaction with the PI. He told me the CM office appointments on the CM and minister's offices are done and issued by the General Administration Department. So everything is monitored by the GAD. So that much role restricted we have, but he clearly told me there is no such committee in CM's office and no such committee in any minister's office. But he was quick to explain me and justify that, saying that in most of the minister's offices there are very few women employees, and that was one of the reason that we didn't have a committee. Subsequently, I immediately pointed him out saying that, but there are 20 women employees in CM's office. So how the law says that if you have, the law says that if you have 10 and more employees, then it is applicable. So why you are not setting up the committee? He told me immediately, this is a policy decision that needs to be taken by the government. So CM office will respond. By the time CM office had sought response from the WCD, Women and Child Development Department, and I think Women Commission as well, and orally they were told that you must need to set up the committee. It can't be that you don't have a committee. So they replied me saying that CM office replied saying that we don't have a committee. I just thought that rather than talking about the CM's office, it won't be right. So I just filed with the same fellow of the GAD. I filed RTI with him saying that whatever you told me, give me in writing. So I filed RTI with the GAD asking whether all the minister's offices have such a committee. Within 10 days, reply was given saying that there is no, except the word that there is no such committee, he had written everything else in the response, saying that how the appointment happens, how these are the tenure post, how these are not permanent job, permanent employees, how they are taken on loan basis, how they are contract, how there are some private guys, everything was there. Only thing he didn't mention that there are no committee for this. He replied, he was a very smart, he worked in Information Commissioner's office. So he replied very smartly saying that in 2016 the State Information Commission has held that each minister's office is a separate public authority, and they need to set up a PIO and appellate authority. So he used that order in my response and said you need to approach all these ministers' offices to get the responses whether they have filed set up the committee or not. And that was the response. But when I went to meet him, sir, ye kya likha hai, likh dite ek line mein ki nahi hai, that's what. So he said it's a sensitive case, how am I going to write that? So when I told him ki CM office ne likh diya hai, to main bhi likh deta, I wasn't aware. So but then he said, so he was like, he understood the issue, and he said like, don't write something against us, and it will give a negative image of the government, and wait for some more days. I said, why wait and what? He said, let this March end happen, and we will do something in this, because it was in February. I didn't say anything to him. I just came back and I just filed the story. The story appeared on 1st March. 8th March is the Women's Day. I don't know whether it's a coincidence or how, on 7th March, the government issued a government resolution, GR, saying that we have set up a committee, not just for CM, but all the minister's offices, and all these women employees working in the minister's offices and CM's office will be covered under this. That was the impact that had and led to the formation of the committee. So that was my good and bad experiences So one, I would like, so again, one, I had filed application with the tribal development department. The officer was, so I had given the time. So it was between in the initial days when I started filing inspection. When I gave the date and time to inspect, the officer was visibly upset, saying that, how did you give me a date and time for the inspection? You are not boss, I am the boss. And he lectured me for 5 minutes, saying that how the government works. And I was like patiently listening to him, saying that, I don't know, sir, you please explain it to me. So he was explaining everything, how there is a secretary, deputy secretary, joint secretary, deputy secretary, under secretary, section officer, clerk, and peon. The entire structure he was explaining, I listened to him. I just said at the end of the conversation, sir, bas mujhe ye bata dijiye, main aage kab aau? Matlab, after how many days shall I come here for the inspection? He said, come after 4 days. Then he again said, no, come next time. And that was the thing. So it's both way it happens. Some, in some cases, the PIOs are very useful, but I can, as of now, whatever the limited experience I have so far, I can say that it is good and always healthy to have an interaction with the PIOs. Never ever consider the public information officer and PIOs as our anti-RTI guys, or they are likely or pro to deny the information. Never consider them as our enemy or enemy of the RTI Act. It is just that they are overburdened with the work. They are lazy guys, might be the case. Only thing, if we are seeking information under inspection under RTI, just say to that PIO on the very first meeting, sir, I'm here to reduce your work burden. Sir, I'm here not to bother you. I don't want you to look into the file and bring out that one page for me. I don't want to bother you. You have much more work to do. You are working for the government, and all that work you have, do that work. I don't bother you. I don't want to take and waste your time. Just bring that file in front of me. I will just sit in front of you and we'll inspect the file. In most of these cases, it has worked in my favor in getting the information, and in most of the cases, it has also turned it out the stories. So that's the one tip or one lesson I have learned so far from these experiences, and which I feel is the most important, because for me, it's like every day I need to look for the stories, and I can't have a like denial and then go for appeal and they go for second appeal. My strategy I always prefer is that I never go for first appeal or second appeal until and unless it is important and there is no other way. First appellate authority is the HOD of the same guy. He will side with him, that is much obvious. In very few cases, the first appellate authority will take the neutral side or will have a neutral this thing. So going to the second appeal and wasting that much and giving that much time is difficult for me as a journalist. But I do go in some cases, but not always. So there are few tips and lessons that I have learned. I will just tell you in short. One is that PIOs are friends and not anti-RTI guys or enemies. Second thing is that whenever we are filing an RTI, either for inspection or for seeking information or anything, what I have always done is that I have done a little background check of that information. Do Google, go to the Google, check out what the information is available there on the website, all the websites or of that particular department, what information is available and what exactly like I want to do the story. Is that I do a little bit of background check. Second is that I normally file RTI with the concerned person and with the concerned department. For example, if I'm filing a PWD, so this is to avoid delay of reaching the application to the PIO. Normally what happens if I'm filing an application saying that PWD secretary Mantrale, then it will go to him, then this fellow will take 3-4 days and then he will send, this is with that desk, particular desk or department division, and send this application, he will transfer it, and then the actual PIO will see it after maybe 8 days or 10 days, and then he will think about what information, whether inspection should be allowed, whether information should be given and all that. So this time goes, so I avoid this completely. I don't get into
into this. What I do is that I just go to the website. Under section 4, there are 17 proactive disclosures that each and every public authority has to do. I go through that 17 public disclosures. I check out who are the PIOs. I check out which are the subjects and topics that they are handling, because that is mentioned in that disclosures. So if you check that, you will get an idea who is exact PIO. For example, when I was filing an RTI with the PWD about the Shivaji Memorial Project, I was specifically writing PIO of Building 3. Imarati Teen. That is the desk that they used to call. So when I used to write that, and with that information, when I gave it to the that Tapal section, I used to tell that guy, this is for Imarati 3. Then that person knew ki haan ye specific hai aur udhar hi bhejna hai. Then there was no delay. The next day the application is reaching to the PIO. So the PIO is having ample time. Most of the time what PIOs feel that मुझे मिलने के बाद 10-15 दिन का टाइम मिलना चाहिए. दैट काइंड ऑफ एटीट्यूड नॉर्मली दे हैव, मतलब इनिशियल 5-7 डेज का टाइम. सो व्हाट आई डू इज दैट फिगर आउट एग्जैक्ट पीआईओ एंड डेस्क एंड मेंशन दैट विद द अथॉरिटी सो दैट इट शुड रीच नेक्स्ट डे और 2 डेज आफ्टर दैट, बट नॉट मोर देन दैट. सो दैट वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ अवॉइडिंग डिले इन गेटिंग द इन्फॉर्मेशन. द अनदर थिंग, as and when you feel that there is a issue and topic, file it immediately. There, matlab, we should not waste any time in that, because once we file the application, once we file PIO to reply within that 30 days of stipulated period. But if you are filing an inspection, it is within 10-15 days, because in some cases what happens, the PIO will go on leave. So in one of the case, what has happened, that PIO was on leave. So I had asked that fellow, who is there? So there is nobody, he said. मैंने बोला ऐसे थोड़ी होता है, मतलब there should be someone. So he said, नहीं है, this office is like that because there is less manpower. So I told him, look, if you have read the RTI Act, it says that there should be an assistant public information officer. The post should be there, or the work should be assigned to someone. So is that you ask that fellow and give me the inspection of that this thing. So they were little surprised. Then they said, aap wait karo, hum ek do din mein kuch karke aapko inspection de dete. So then that's how it works on. One of the case that I forgot to mention about is, we have a Maharashtra Public Records Act. That is for if the file is missing or not available, and in that case, a case is arrested and inquiry is instituted. I had filed one RTI with a particular department in Mantralay. When I sought the information, they said, this information is not available with us. I said, fine, transfer it to the concerned authority. They transferred it to that authority. They said, no, this file is not with us because this project was there. I said, okay, transfer there. So both the department who handled the project are saying the file is not with us. I went and met that PIO. I said, look, if you don't have a file, say there is no file, I will take care of the rest thing. So he said, what would you do? I will just ask the... So these most of the guys are not aware of the RTI Act and the provisions. So I randomly said, I will go to the Information Commission and say, this file is missing and register an FIR against this fellow. And this fellow got frightened. He said, don't do these things. We will give us 2-3 days time and we will figure out a way. And within 2-3 days, the file surfaces and he tells me that there is a file, you can come and inspect. Now, in this Public Records Act, this fellow, matlab, that is another act, RTI is another act, but you just have to use sometimes the tricks and techniques to, so that he should have an impression that you are well versed with the act and knows the provisions well, so that he won't trouble you much. That's the next thing. Another thing and important aspect of getting immediate or fast responses. While we are filing an inspection, what is most important fact is that we must know the exemption clauses of the RTI. When I was filing RTI whenever I file RTI pertaining to the particular minister or a sensitive case involving any major project and all these things, my first concern or check is that what PIO will think. How he will think to reject the application? What are the sections he is likely to invoke? I will look for that. I will check that out, and accordingly I will frame my RTI so that I won't give him a chance. I won't allow him to deny the information and go into the appeal. So we must be aware of that exemption clauses. A broad idea we must have so that accordingly we can frame the applications and seek the informations. Then another thing is that So in case of Shivaji Memorial, what has happened? So that's the a tip or experience that I had learned. This PIO is troubling me. I should file RTI with that department so that he will give me immediate information. So the thing is that if the same information is available with two different authorities, then file RTI with the two different authorities. One will respond immediately, one may not. But at least what our purpose is that we will get the information and like we may be able to bring out a story or an issue out of that. So these are the some of the experiences or lessons that I have learned through these PIOs that RTIs that I have filed in last 2 years. Of late, I have started using online mechanism that we have for the center as well and for the state. So online is a much easier like that happens that I feel because in last couple of 2 months I filed 2 RTIs and that they transfer it. So normally the 5 days time limit is being given in the act, but what my experience in last 2 months is that within 2 to 3 days they transfer the application to the immediate authorities. And the good way is that they online they communicate us online how much payment has to be made and all that things. So that much hassle we don't have. We have to pay online itself, and then they provide you the information through email or that portal itself. So that reduces my burden of going and physically submitting the application to that particular department, because it takes for me I have to starting in the morning itself I have to decide okay, in which time period I have a time and go to that particular office and submit my application. So that time has now my time has been saved now because of this online applications. And now I do the other thing. I normally do the application in the morning itself if I have an idea and start my day with that.
But that so, means less child from the PROs now.
Less
child from the PROs.
No.
Online.
No. Though I am filing an online application, I do go and meet these guys. As my like practice, I have continued so far. So that's what I have to say. Whenever I go to meet officers, so in some cases, if the I know officer very well, then I normally go meet and we will have a chat for 15 minutes, half an hour. There is no issue with that. In some cases, if I need to break an ice with that officer, I need to be friendly with that officer, I do one thing is that I go and I say, I just say that, sir, I need a cup of coffee, a cup of tea. I on my own say it to him. So he normally says, since I am a journalist, he doesn't say no. So wait for 2 to 3 minutes. He will order tea. And in all, it takes 10 minutes. So mandatorily or by force, he has to speak with me for 10 minutes. And I use that time to like build a rapport and all these things. So that's how I use that trick of tea. So that's what I had to share. Thank you.
Excellent. Congratulations. Give you a big hand. Everyone has a lot of questions. Let me start with mine. Have you filed any RTI on Coastal Road? Have you done any?
Not yet. We had a discussion about this. My colleague is the one who is covering BMC and reporting on the Coastal Road. We have discussed on that, but we haven't yet formulated RTI and we haven't yet filed. We are, as I mentioned you, figuring out what information is in public domain and what aspects and what information we need to seek. Is that what we are figuring out? Soon we will be filing that.
Okay. I
working with activists for it.
Yeah. Sujita's question was, are you working with any activists?
No. I don't. In our office is that it encourages reporters to file RTIs.
On their own?
On our own. So okay. I file RTIs on my own and my colleagues are also there. So if they have any issues or they want to file RTIs, I help them out in the offices.
Okay, you give us a lot of examples about filing RTIs and getting response from the government, PWD and ministers and Mantralay. What about BMC? Are they as well responsive?
So my experience with BMC was not that good like Mantralay. Maybe I don't know, but in BMC the response time was very less. They took 20 days or more time to respond and all that things. And in respect of my applications, they were not pro disclosing the information or all that things. So but I had filed not much applications with the BMC like I did with the Mantralay case.
And who is the contractor for the Shivaji's third?
Shivaji L&T.
Can I ask a question, please?
Sure, sir.
Strange question. Have you ever filed an RTI with the Office of the State Chief Information Commissioner himself?
Not yet.
I have. I filed a complaint also later on. The complaint disappeared. I filed an RTI upon the complaint. Appeals also were not heard.
Okay.
Complaint under Section 18.
Huh.
Till today, no track of it.
Okay. So it is with the Mumbai bench?
Yeah. The State Chief Information Commissioner himself.
Okay, now the post is vacant, that fellow is...
No, Sumit Malik is there now.
He is the Chief Information Commissioner.
His office.
Okay.
His office specifically.
1300 crore rupees in the Shivaji statue have been reduced by just changing 7.5 meters?
No, so 7.5 meters is the one of the aspect to reduce those. 350 crore in one go, they have reduced with that aspect. Then what they did was that they have reduced some portion, for example, of EIP house that they had in the project that they removed. Oh. Then they reduced the size of the hospital that they have. Then they deleted one jetty, saying that we don't need this jetty. So what they did was they reduced the scope of the work and they deferred some scope of the work for the next phase, and that's they have claiming that the amount has been reduced.
तुम्ही मंत्रालयात बरच काम केलेले आहे, तर मला हे विचारायचं की आपण जेव्हा एक इन्स्पेक्शन ऑफ डॉक्युमेंट साठी फाईल करतो सेक्शन 4 मध्ये, तर मी सहसा ते केलेलं आणि शैलेश भाईंचं मला उत्तर मिळालं रे एका याच्यावरती, तर त्याचा मला बराच फायदा झाला. तर हे विचारायचं की नॉर्मल जेव्हा आपण क्वेश्चन विचारतो त्यांना की याच्यावरती, एखादा मी स्कूलच्या ॲडमिशनबद्दल विचारलेलं की आधार कार्ड मॅन्डेटरी आहे असं बऱ्याच स्कूलमधून सांगण्यात आलं, तर मी म्हटलं की याला काही आधार आहे का, मंत्रालयाकडून काही नोटिफिकेशन आहे का, तर मी एज्युकेशन डिपार्टमेंटला विचारलं. एक महिना झाला काही उत्तर आलेलं नाही, तर हाऊ वी कॅन गेट आन्सर थ्रू RTI ऑन दिस, कारण क्वेश्चन सहसा विचारू शकत नाही, ते कसं करता येईल?
Maybe with the education department, we can seek the particular file asking on what. So, for example, so I will give you an idea how to deal with, whether it is BMC or any government department, how to deal with these things. So, whenever we have questions, I had questions, I never asked them, I just asked for the entire inspection of the file. Entire file. Don't ask questions, because in file you will have, so in file there are two sections. One is notings and other is correspondence. In noting section, whatever the discussions and discussions have happened between the minister, secretary and all the officials, that is recorded in that section, noting section, and based on that the correspondence is happening. Okay. So what happens if there is a particular letter issued by someone? Look at the letter's number carefully. The letter has a particular number mentioned in that, saying, for example, the letter gives a number. With the date, there is a number. So look for that number. Okay. There is a reference in that which gives you an access to another correspondence. So quote that number and just say that I want to inspect all the documents pertaining to this. So in Mantralaya, I will give you an example. If you look at any GR, it says Shashan Nirnay. No. Then it says Sankirna. Otherwise, it will say Nasti file. Okay. It will then it will have a name of that desk slash it will give a prakra and number. Prakra is file kramank. Okay. That file number, for example, 40, 41, 50, whatever. And then it says that ta is like that particular desk that deals with the subject. So when I read the government resolutions, I read with that. So when I am filing an inspection, I will just quote that file number with that particular desk. So that becomes easier for the PIO to bring out that file. And that becomes easier for him to show me the file immediately, because he doesn't have to find out. I am just mentioning the subject and the file number. So in your case, if you have any school letter issued, if they have any references in their letter mentioned of any government communication, just look for that and look for the number. Just ask for the inspection of that particular this thing. You will get an idea about how it has started and who has issued instructions or orders.
I'm taking some time.
तुम्ही फक्त एज्युकेशन डिपार्टमेंटला विचारलं की द स्कूल्स आर आस्किंग फॉर आधार कार्ड बिकॉज दे वॉन्ट टू अपलोड द इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द चिल्ड्रेन इन द सरल पोर्टल.
ओके,
सो हॅव यू इन्स्ट्रक्टेड द स्कूल्स ऑन दिस दॅट आधार इज मँडेटरी, प्लीज गिव मी द इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट दिस. सो दॅट वॉज नॉट अंडर आर टी आय बट अ नॉर्मल क्वेश्चन वॉज आस्क्ड. Since the answer is not forthcoming, I want to just ask them, please give me this information. Since there is nothing letter or anything on which I can base my information, so it is a little bit vague.
Okay, but from the school, is there anything?
No, it's verbal.
Supreme Court has given judgment last year on 26 September, and Supreme Court has clearly mentioned Aadhaar is not required for school education. In fact, a few months back, the SET, for SET exams, the Pune University has mandated Aadhaar, the online form. And they are not accepting the application unless and until you fill the Aadhaar number there. So I asked them that why you are asking this number, because I had quoted the Supreme Court judgment. I gave them the exact portion what Supreme Court has said, and they removed the mandatory requirement.
Okay.
So similar way, you can go and find the Supreme Court judgment, or you can check on our website. It is there. You take that portion and show it to the authority who is asking for Aadhaar.
Yeah. No, the question again remains the same. Government departments don't reply. So, in what way?
Sir, I think you can come on the Wednesday and no, Mr. Gandhi will guide you.
No, I have already replied to him, but.
So, we take it forward because a lot of other questions. Thanks.
Have you filed any RTI with the cooperation department, like with the cooperation department, like deputy registrar, deputy district registrar, division joint registrar?
No, I have filed in Mantralaya, but not with the district registrar or any other departments. But I have filed in Mantralaya with the cooperation department particularly, okay. Because I had few issues and files to inspect, but not like district registrar and deputy registrar if you are referring to. Okay. I haven't.
On your guidance, I filed around 10 RTIs in the last 3 months, and fortunately, I got the reply within 3 days, getting the copy of some minutes filed by the society for the redevelopment purpose under Section 79A. I find out there was a fraud by the society. I took the attention of the deputy registrar. Immediately, in this very same day, he cancelled the permission. But subsequently, society managed to get the permission again. I met the few politician MLA and MP's assistant and took the objection. And now what he replied in response to my RTI is, since there is some confusion between society, the permission is not being granted. Okay. What I want him to say, okay, under section so-and-so, since the compliance is not done, we are not granting permissions. So based on that, I want to take the further file charges against society members.
Okay.
So it's really a drafting of the applications.
For the society purpose, you can come on Tuesday and meet Mr. Shanbar.
You already met him, and we move on the matter.
My question is related to what you said, section 4 and 17 disclosures. Could you explain what you meant by that? And my other question is with regard to what you say when you file these applications. I mean, when you're coming regularly, people will want to know what you do. And if you say you're a journalist, people will get scared. So how do you deal with that? What do you say? What do you do?
So two questions. So I will answer first. In under section 4, there are 17 disclosures in which the every public authority has to disclose the information, like the name of the officers that they have, their pay scale, their what the role of the role that they have in that authority assigned to each one, the PIOs, who are the PIOs, who are the first public first appellate authority, and their offices and other related information. So that's there. So it is just to use it while filing an application, because we will know exactly who is the PIO to particular our case. So that's why I use that section 4 ka disclosures to get an idea who is the PIO, so that my application should reach him immediately and not like after some couple of days. One. Your second question was that how do I deal with when I as a journalist. So my so in my application I do mention that address is that Indian Express, Mafatlal Center and Nariman Point. But in 50% or most of the cases, what happens, there are some PIOs who are not aware what Indian Express is. So I keep quiet. I don't say anything. I just go like as a citizen, and I just say that sir, maine RTI dala hai, and I have come here for the inspection. सो देन ही विल डील लाइक आज नहीं कल आ जाओ दो दिन बाद आ जाओ काम है बहुत यही है क्या. ही विल कीप ऑन सेइंग दैट बट आई डोंट से एनीथिंग. आई विल जस्ट कीप क्वाइट. आई विल जस्ट से सर यू सीम टू बी लॉट हैव अ लॉट ऑफ वर्क बट आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू बॉदर यू. आई हैव जस्ट हियर कम हियर टू रिड्यूस यूर वर्क लाइक इफ दिस आर टी आई इज एन अगेन. सो नॉर्मली आई डू दिस. आई टेल हिम दैट आर टी आई इज लॉट ऑफ हेडेक फॉर यू बिकॉज दिस इज लाइक नॉन सेंस एवरी टाइम दिस इज कमिंग पीपल आर ट्रबलिंग यू एंड डूइंग दिस बट I am here to help you. I am not here to bother you. I am not here to trouble you. So I tell him and then he feels okay. Then he looks at me and he looks at me. Then I says, sir, what I want and what I expect from you is that give me the file. I will inspect on my own and I will tell you the exact numbers of that pages. So you don't have to do anything. You will have to just count the numbers. Give me a letter. Pay this much amount. I will pay that amount and xerox, give me the xerox copies. That much matlab work you will have to do. Otherwise rest I will take care of. So he feels little like good. हाँ मतलब मेरा काम कम हो गया ठीक है. And then with that conversation he says then come 2 days 3 days after that and I will give you the file. And in some cases as you mentioned that people get to know that I'm a journalist. So there are two things happen. One they deny the information and second because I'm a journalist they will give me the information on time. So that advantage I have in some cases. So that's how it goes on. But if the person doesn't know that I am a journalist, then I don't tell him that I am a journalist. In most of the cases, in such cases, what has happened that they do ask me, why do you want this information? What you are going to do with that? And I just tell them very frankly and plainly that I am doing study on this. And this fellow says like what? No, I want to understand the issue completely. And without this file, I won't be able to understand. And then he agrees with that. But the most of the PIs have agreed with that. And that's it. Nothing more than that.
Sir, you talked about the last GR, 26th November, yeah. 2018. Yeah. So what we experience is most of the department, this GR doesn't work at all. Specifically with the Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai. They have given me in writing, the commissioner's office. They are yet to receive the orders for this GR. So this GR is not working. Most of our activities, it is not working in any department in Mumbai. So what is your take? You said you...
So have you, matlab, in your application, had you attached the GR with this or how? Did you attach the GR with your application?
Most of our activists actually have gone with this GR copies and they have refused. Even I have written to the commissioner's office. They have given me in writing. Okay, this order is, this thing is not applicable because they have not received yet.
Yeah. So in normal circumstances, no authority can say that they haven't received a government resolution. Government resolution is circulated and given to all the public authorities that to which the RTI is applicable. Now in this case, if the so normally what happens, this is again another mentality, like a way of looking at it, is that the officers, the PIOs and the government authorities are reluctant to allow us the inspection on a weekly basis because this gives us powers to do the inspection on a weekly basis. So it will require, I think, more time to, it will require more efforts from our side to put pressure on the government and authorities to fall in the line, like to accept it and follow the rules. So maybe we need to, if at all that is the case, then we may need to take it up either with the commission or with the GAD, complaining that this is being, GR is being flouted and not being implemented, and something might work from there.
How about filing an RTI to know when the office received the GR copy, the timestamp and date stamp, whether you had received and on what date you had received. If you had not received, tell in writing so that you can raise the question again. Any more?
To seek the information by through inspection, what we should mention in the RTI, because so far I mentioned only I want the informations by the post.
So when I file an RTI inspection, in the subject line I clearly mentioned that inspection information related to, for example, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj Memorial. And in the description of the information I say that all the inspection of all Nasti files records pertaining to then I mentioned that these committee meetings, okay? And then, as I mentioned you, if you have a file number, matlab if you have, so normally do one thing, whenever we are filing an RTI, do have a look at the related documents of the governments. So you will get a reference and idea of that and use that wordings and their numbers, code that, so it becomes easier for them. So for example, if I'm filing an RTI, say, I will say related to this particular file, in bracket, file number is this. So that much I say, and the below I mentioned that kindly keep entire files, records, documents ready for the inspection. I will come on this day at this time.
Okay.
But besides that, this is what I do. I don't know whether it has worked in my favor because nobody has asked me. But besides that, in below I mention, I quote section 2J of the RTI Act that clearly mentions what is the inspection and what is allowed in the inspection. So it says all government records, documents and everything is, anybody can inspect RTI records and everything. So I quote that section 2J entirely in my application. And then again I mention 4.4, section 4, subsection 4, which talks about dissemination of the information in, like, even if it is floppies, disk and everything, whether it is in index and everything. So I quote these two sections in my application. So the other thing that I wanted to tell you, that I believe and I assume that all the PIOs are not aware and are not well versed with the sections of the RTI. So normally I quote these two sections in my application itself, saying that, dear PIO, please note, and this is what section says under RTI Act for the inspection. So most of the time, so far I haven't yet come across why you have put it into it. Nobody has said it to me. So I'm continuing with that.
If I require a lot of information, I written a letter to the one government authority on 25th of March. It was a 10-page letter. Simply, in the very next day, I file a RTI mentioning the reply to this letter. So will this be suffice?
Same
if I have the very lengthy information, a lot of information,
huh.
I do file the multiple RTIs, I understand. Because there is a limit of the wordings.
150 words limit is there.
Right.
And that also, that the information we seek, it should be related to one subject, not two subjects.
Right.
So that is there, then we have to file multiple RTIs.
So I filed one letter seeking the information, and the very same day I filed the RTI, reply to letter dated so and so. I have not received the reply so far.
Okay, but
this is the proper method.
So normally you have to give them some time.
Huh?
No, but this is okay.
So if you have filed a letter, then
this
you, have
to give, okay,
right? You have to give them some time at least to reply to you.
सर रायगड डिस्ट्रिक्ट मध्ये श्रीवर्धनमधून बोलतोय. तर श्रीवर्धनमध्ये नगर परिषदेने काय केलंय की आमच्या वाडीमध्ये चार ड्रेनेज पास करून घेतले आणि चार ड्रेनेजपैकी फक्त एकच ड्रेनेज बनवली, ड्रेनेज लाईन. तर ते त्याच्यानंतर कळलं की तिथल्या टाईल्स काढल्या आणि तिथे फक्त सिमेंट काँक्रीट केलं आहे. त्याच्यासाठी नंतर मग काय, जे पाणी आहे, नळाचं पाणी आहे, ते सगळीकडे पसरते रोज. आणि गेल्या सप्टेंबर 2018 मी RTI वगैरे टाकतो आहे. तर त्याच्यात ते कवरिंग लेटरमध्ये ते रिप्लाय बरोबर देत आहेत, पण जे इन्फॉर्मेशन मी मागितली होती की मला तुम्ही टेंडरचं कॉपी द्या, त्याच्यानंतर गेल्या 10 वर्षातले त्यांना तुम्ही टेंडर वर्क अलॉट केलं आहे त्याची लेटरची सर्टिफाईड कॉपी द्या, त्याच्यानंतर वर्क कम्प्लिशनची ऑर्डर द्या, आणि जे बिल पास केले आहेत ह्या चार पद्धतीच्या कॉपीज मी मागितल्या. तर त्यांनी कवरिंग लेटरमध्ये माझ्या कोळीवाड्याचं नाव लिहितात, पण ते लेटर अगोदर दिलं ते दुसऱ्याच कोळीवाड्याचे दिले. त्याच्यानंतर पुन्हा मी अपीलमध्ये गेलो. अपीलमध्ये गेल्यावरती मला एकच ठिकाणचं फक्त मिळालं, बाकी तीन केलेलेच नाहीत, तर ते मिळणार कुठून. मग मी सेकंड अपीलमध्ये कोकण भवनला गेलो आहे. पण त्याच्याचबरोबर जे पहिलं रिप्लाय ज्या त्यांनी दिलं होतं, त्याच्यासाठी मी वर्क इन्स्पेक्शन करण्याच्यासाठी मी लेटर लिहिलं. तर वर्क इन्स्पेक्शनसाठी परवाच्या दिवशी त्यांचे ते इंजिनियर वगैरे आले होते, आणि PIO वगैरे, तर त्यांनी बघितलं की 15 चेंबर्स बनवलेले आहेत. तर नंतर मग त्यांनी बघितलं की हे काँक्रीटिंग करण्याचं काम होतं, त्याच्यामुळे इथे ड्रेनेज नाही आहे. मग म्हटलं 15 चेंबर्स कशाला बनवलेत, ड्रेनेजच नाही तर चेंबर कशाला. अरे बापरे, आता काय करायचं, मग तुम्हाला काय नवीन ड्रेनेज पाहिजे आहे का? म्हटलं मला ते माहीत नाही, तुम्हाला जे वर्क इन्स्पेक्शनमध्ये मिळालं ते मला तुम्ही द्या. आता म्हणजे या स्टेजला मी काल परवापर्यंत आलो आहे. आता त्यांनी कामच केलेलं नाही आणि पैसे खाऊन बसलेत गव्हर्नमेंटचे. हे फक्त माझ्या एकाच वाडीतले, असं सगळीकडेच होत असणार. मग पुढे ॲक्शन काय घ्यायची? हे पोल खोल झालेलं आहे डायरेक्ट, त्यांच्याजवळ काही उत्तर नाही. पण आता माझी ॲक्शन काय असावी?
पब्लिश करायला पाहिजे.
हां, दॅट इज द वे फॉरवर्ड.
सर, पीसीजीटी मधून हे दिग्विजय तरटे आहेत, पब्लिक कन्सर्न फॉर गव्हर्नर ट्रस्ट मधून रिबेरो साहेबांची जी ट्रस्ट आहे आणि त्या तिथून ते मला हेल्प करतात. रंगराव सर वगैरे जे आहेत तर हे लोक माझ्या मला मदत करतात. पण काय आता करावं तुम्ही पण सांगा जरा.
हो, आपण बोलूया.
आपण जेव्हा इन्स्पेक्शनला जातात कुठलेही डॉक्युमेंट चेक करतात अकॉर्डिंग टू द जी आर, ते गव्हर्नमेंटने लास्ट इयर आणलं होतं. आम्ही गेलो होतो चॅरिटी कमिशनर ऑफिसमध्ये विथ जी आर. ते बोलले की तुम्ही फक्त डॉक्युमेंट बघू शकता, वाचू शकता, पण त्याची तुम्ही फोटो पण नाही घेऊ शकत आणि झेरॉक्सेस पण नाही घेऊ शकत. कारण की जी आरमध्ये असं काय मेन्शन केलं नाही आहे की तुम्हाला फोटो कॉपी दिली पाहिजे या डॉक्युमेंटची. मग आम्हाला फक्त बघावं लागलं, कारण की आणि डॉक्युमेंटमध्ये काय आहे ते फक्त लिहून घ्यावं लागलं, पण त्यांनी फोटो कॉपीज दिली नाही. मग तुम्ही अशा सिच्युएशनला कसे डील करता? तुम्हाला ते फोटो कॉपीज देतात का, तुम्ही ॲप्लिकेशन लिहिता की काय करता?
इथं दोन गोष्टी. एक, मी जे आत्ता ॲप्लिकेशन फाईल करतो आहे ते एक्झिस्टिंग ठिकाणीच करतो आहे, म्हणजे ते पी आय ओ मला माहिती आहेत, मी त्यांना माहिती आहे, आणि त्याच्यामुळं मी फक्त तो जी आर जोडतो आणि त्यांना देतो, तर त्याच्यामुळं ते मला लगेच माहिती देतात कारण त्यांना आधीपासून मी त्यांच्याशी टचमध्ये आहे. दुसरा मुद्दा तुम्ही म्हणाला की ते झेरॉक्स देता येत नाहीत किंवा लिहून घेता येत नाही वगैरे किंवा हे, आता मुळात ते इन्स्पेक्शनचं एक असं आहे की तुम्हाला फक्त पेन्सिलने काही लिहून घ्यायचं असेल तर ते घेता येतं. त्याच्यासाठी एक गव्हर्नमेंट नोटिफिकेशन 2012 काढणं नोटिफिकेशन, पण तुम्हाला फाईलवरती काही लिहिता येत नाही. पण इन्स्पेक्शन सुरू असताना तुम्ही पेन्सिलने नोटिंग करू शकता, जे मी काही केसेसमध्ये करतो. म्हणजे मी तो सेक्शन मग कोट करतो माझ्या आर टी ॲप्लिकेशनमध्ये की 2012 जे नोटिफिकेशन तुम्ही इश्यू केलेलं आहे त्याच्यानुसार पेन्सिलनं नोटिंग लिहिता येतं मला आणि मी ते करणार आहे, तर त्यामुळे ते करू देतात. दुसरा मुद्दा तुम्ही म्हणाला की त्या जी आरमध्ये कॉपीज देता येत नाही. आता तो जी आर जर तुम्ही वाचला तर तो जी आर इतका क्लिष्ट बनवला आहे त्यांनी की त्याच्यात एक शब्द आणि वाक्य असं आहे की दर सोमवारी इन्स्पेक्शन द्यावं, पण त्याच्यात असं वाक्य म्हटलेलं आहे त्यांनी विहित प्रक्रिया पूर्ण करून. आता ती विहित प्रक्रिया काय हे पडलेलं कोड आहे, म्हणजे मी असं मग गृहित धरून चाललेलो आहे की विहित प्रक्रिया म्हणजे अर्ज, म्हणून आपण अर्ज करायचा आणि ते हे करायचं. आता राहिला प्रश्न तुम्ही माहिती देत नाही म्हणजे ते म्हणतायत म्हणजे कॉपीज देता येत नाही, तर मी एक आता तुम्हाला अनुभव सांगतो. जी ई डीमध्ये मी आर टी आय मागच्या जानेवारीत टाकला, त्यांनी सांगितलं, म्हणजे मगाशी मी ते सांगायचं विसरून गेलो की पी आय ओ कसे गमतीशीर असतात हा किस्सा आता सांगतो त्या निमित्तानं. मराठी ओके शुड आय इन इंग्लिश. सो आय फाईल्ड अन आर टी आय ॲप्लिकेशन विथ जी ई डी आस्किंग फॉर द इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ पर्टिक्युलर फाईल बिकॉज दे हॅड इशूड अ जी आर. आय गॉट टू नो दॅट द नॉर्मली वॉट हॅपन्स वेन यू आर आस्किंग इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट कॅबिनेट पेपर्स अँड कॅबिनेट डिसिजन्स, इट हॅज टू हॅपन अँड देन ओनली इफ द ॲक्शन इज कम्प्लीट देन दे डिस्क्लोज यू द इन्फॉर्मेशन. द कॅबिनेट हॅड टेकन डिसिजन, द फॉर्मल ऑर्डर वॉज इश्यूड ऑन दॅट, अँड सबसिक्वेंटली आय फाईल्ड अन ॲप्लिकेशन सेईंग दॅट प्लीज गिव्ह मी अ इन्स्पेक्शन ऑफ दॅट फाईल. It was pertaining to the Shivaji Memorial Project. So that fellow replied to me saying that the work is going on in the file and we regret, amala khed hotoy, we regret to inform you that ki the information inspection of the information of the file cannot be given until the completion of the project. I was surprised with the fact that ki prakalpa purna hoi paryanta maiti deta yet nahi. I read that, I laughed and I didn't say anything. I just filed first appeal. I just told, matlab in my appeal I took the ground saying that there is no provision under the RTI Act that says that the information cannot be given until the completion of the project. Okay, so there is no such provision. I made a point saying that you are wrong in saying so. And secondly, I said ki then I like differentiated saying that GAD is an administration department that is not an implementing agency for the Shivaji Memorial Project. I told in my raised in my application saying that PWD is an implementing agency for the project, then how you are going to monitor and what is your lookout in that? Your role is restricted and limited in respect to the file and that much you should do. So I went to the appeal. They that deputy secretary was the first appellate authority. She said who said that action is complete on the file. I said, I told her this is my contention that the action is complete on the file. So then she said, I agree with all your these things, but I don't agree with this because when you filed an RTI there was some work going on, that's why we didn't give you the information. But we are, so I asked, are you giving me information now? She said yes. So I said fine, but in that order, what she said, really a very interesting thing. She said, you can be allowed only, you can, this applicant can be allowed to the inspection, but not giving the copies of the that file. And but she corrected itself in the oral hearing, but in the written order it came out that only inspection should be given to this fellow and not the copies of the file. So I went for the inspection. They issued letter asking to come for the inspection. So normally I don't have an argument with any PIO. So I was sitting with the two guys, that JD. I was having a chat and I told him, if you want, I can file another application and get the copies from you. But just think, I told him, just think, since you have not given me the copies of the these files that I have demanded, it means that the application is not closed. Application is open and it will be on you. The onus will be on you to give me the information, otherwise it will lead to penalty on you. I clearly told him that PIO, this is like a violation and this does not close the my RTI. He took 5 minutes and he said, okay, information later. So in your case also, what you do is that, my suggestion is that whenever you go for the inspection, note down the pages of this. Just mention that pages and give him in writing saying that I have done the inspection on this and this date during this hour. I want these many pages of this file for copies of these pages. And please do let me know the fees that needs to be paid for that. So put it on record saying that you have done the inspection and you want these many copies, because they cannot deny under RTI ki you cannot be given the copies. Right. They cannot.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. I think we'll bring the session to an end. It's a wonderful, very, very informative session, including for all of us here who are activists and who've been filing regularly. So let's give Vishwas a big hand.
Thanks.
We also have a small memento for you. I'm going to ask Yogesh to present it. There are two books on RTI by information commissioners. One of them is Sailesh, the other is Sridhar Acharyalu. Thank you so much.